to Britain now, where Boris Johnson's call for an early election to break the Brexit deadlock has been defeated for a second time. And joining us now live from London is SBS Europe correspondent Ben Lewis. Ben, what happens now?
Well, Ricardo, around Westminster, not a great deal because Parliament has been prorogued, suspended for 5 weeks at the orders of the Prime Minister. His critics say it's an absolute disgrace. Boris Johnson had hoped that today would be the first day of an official election campaign. That's not to be, and it leaves him in a very tricky position.
An election could be the trigger needed to break the Brexit deadlock. All parties want it. The fight is over when it should happen. For a second time, Boris Johnson's bid for a snap poll before the October 31st Brexit deadline failed.
Not only have they refused to choose the way ahead, they have now twice denied the British people their say in an election.
Opposition MPs won't allow him one until they're certain a no-deal exit has been prevented.
This government is a disgrace, and the way the Prime Minister operates is a disgrace.
It was the closing blow in another bad day for the Prime Minister. He left his name in the Irish Taoiseach's guestbook.
Michel Barnier has been here last day,
but didn't achieve any real movement on the border issue during his brief visit to Dublin. While back in London, MPs ordered his government to hand over the private messages of senior Downing Street staff, as well as secret no-deal contingency plans. Mr Johnson is likely relieved he won't have to turn up to the Commons for a little while. Parliament has been prorogued for 5 weeks. The Prime Minister insists it's so the government can lay out a new domestic agenda.
No matter how many devices this Parliament invents to tie my hands, I will strive, Mr Speaker, to get an agreement in the national interest.
Opponents say that's nonsense.
Parliament should be sitting and Parliament should be holding the government to account, and the Prime Minister appears to be wanting to run away from questions.
And so MPs now return to their constituencies. They won't be back here until October the 14th. It's the longest suspension of Parliament in modern times during what is perhaps the biggest political crisis the UK has faced since the Second World War.
When it does come back, there'll be a little less of this. The Speaker of the House announcing he's standing down at the end of October, jumping before he was pushed by Conservatives who've accused him of bias. John Bercow using the occasion to take a parting shot at the Prime Minister.
We degrade this Parliament at our peril.
But the power of Parliament will soon be tested after the Queen gave royal assent to a bill that forces the Prime Minister to ask the EU for another Brexit delay if a deal isn't reached by mid-October. Mr Johnson insists he won't do that, meaning the matter will likely end up in the courts. The Commons is closed, but the Brexit crisis continues.
When Parliament does resume in the middle of October, there is every chance that an early election will then be approved, possibly through a no-confidence motion, and that election is likely to take place in late November. That's the chatter around Westminster at the moment anyway. Boris Johnson will go into that public vote with a pretty clear, simple message. Make Brexit happen. Labour's position is far more nuanced. They're saying they'll try and reach a new agreement with the European Union, and then they'll put that new deal to the public through another referendum where Remain will be an option. Ricardo, that's a much tougher sell to the British public, many of whom are simply tired of having to discuss Brexit at all.
OK, Ben Lewis there in London, thank you.